Welcome to my basic mechanical engineering playlist. Today I am going to discuss about steam stop valve, or sometimes it is called as junction valve. So let's see first of all the outlines of the session. For a simple figure of the steam stop valve for the examination. Next, function and location of the steam stop valve. Next, construction of the steam stop valve. Next, working of steam stop valve, and at last animation of the steam stop valve. Now let's see one by one briefly. So here you can see the steam stop valve, and if you zoom in then you will see the steam stop valve like this. In the previous video we have discussed about the steam pressure gauge, water level indicator, safety valve, feed check valve, blow off cope and fusible plug. Now it's turn for the steam stop valve. Steam stop valve is one of the boiler mountings, so it is essential and compulsory part of the boiler to provide safety. This is really a very simple figure of the steam stop valve. And so that definitely you can draw it in the examination. This is the cut section of the steam stop valve so that you can remember this figure in the examination. Now the function of the steam stop valve. It is used to regulate the flow of the steam from boiler to the steam pipe or from the steam pipe to the engine or turbine. So basically there are two functions. First one is to regulate the flow of steam from the boiler to steam pipe, and then to regulate the flow of steam from the steam pipe to the engine or turbine. Now let's see the location of the steam stop valve. For the first purpose, that means to regulate the flow of steam from the boiler to the steam pipe, then it is generally called as the junction valve, and that is placed at the top of shell. For the second purpose, that means if it is used to regulate the flow of steam from the steam pipe to the engine or turbine, then it is known as the steam stop valve. Usually the junction valve has larger size than the stop valve. So very simple, if the valve is near to the boiler then it is called as the junction valve, and if the valve is near to the turbine then it is known as the steam stop valve. Now the construction of the steam stop valve. Here you can see this is once again the very simple figure of the steam stop valve, and so that you can draw it in the examination also. It consists of a valve body, here you can see, made of cast iron, having two flanges. Here you can see two flanges at right angles to each other. One flange is bolted to the boiler at top of the steam space, and the other is connected to the steam pipe. Here you can see, and from that steam pipe you can send the steam to the engine or to the turbine. Lowest end of the spindle is connected to the valve and passes through the gland and yoke. Upper end of the spindle is connected with the handwheel. Gland is generally used to prevent the leakage of the steam. Next, working of the steam stop valve. Here you can see these are the two different position of the steam stop valve. One is in open condition and another one is in closed condition. Simply you can say it is on and this is the off condition. By default the valve is in closed condition and the steam is not allowed to pass through this valve. When the spindle is rotated by hand wheel, valve moves up and down according to the direction of the rotation of this wheel. When the valve moves up, the steam in the boiler is allowed to pass through this steam stop valve. Here you can see steam is allowed to pass from the boiler shell to the steam pipe through this space. Otherwise, by default, it is in off condition like this. This is the cut section of the steam stop valve. And this is the 3D model of the steam stop valve, so that exactly you can understand the construction and working of the steam stop valve. This is the figure of the Lancashire boiler. Here you can see location of the steam stop valve that is generally attached to the top of the boiler shell. Thanks, my dear friends, for watching this video. Press the like button to appreciate it.